Hello everybody, this is an updated video demo of a previous non-narrated version that I have created a few years ago. And in this updated video demo, I would like to talk about the creation of this styling detail. It will also cover some techniques that were not shared during the previous video demo. If a zebra analysis were to be applied on the surface, you'll notice that the transitions were all matched to G2 or curvature for all major connections. The creation of the main base has been covered in a series of video tutorials, and if you'd like to watch them, you can click on this label over here to go to those videos. Okay. Now, let's start. First thing I would like to do is to rotate this object and then align it to the green center line axis. Okay, something like that. And then proceed to create the profile curves. Okay, to ensure that the first and the second point are horizontally aligned. I'll take out the grid snap. Going to move this up so that we can see the curves better in the top view. And I'm going to do some fine adjustments now by using insert node to add a control point somewhere around here, maybe. Maybe something like that. Okay, and I need to draw a horizontal line here as well. And because this object is symmetrical, let's remove this half. Going to do a right mouse click, extract surface. Delete it. And let's trim away this portion by clicking on the trim command and use this as the cutting object. Click on here to remove this region. So I get something like that. And let's remove some of the unnecessary curves. Okay, don't need that. For this demo, let's hide this. And now I need to create the profile over here for the surface. And I reckon one of the ways to do it is to use the adjustable curve blend. Go to select this edge and this edge here, and for one, I need to set it to curvature. However, in the case of two, I don't need it to be curvature, I just need it to be positioned. Okay, I should do a bit of fine adjustments or control point with respect to point one, maybe something like that. Okay, something like that. Okay, and okay, and I can move this point downward like that, and maybe I need to extend this a bit. I'm going to right mouse click, align to object, and drag this arrow to lengthen the curve. Okay, something like that. I'm going to create a surface here. However, I do not want to use this edge. What I'm going to do is let's duplicate a curve that correspond to this edge by using this duplicate edge command. Click on this, enter, and if you were to turn on the control points, you'll notice that there are way too many points here. So what I'm going to do is to reduce the control point by using the review curve non-uniform. Press enter, and I'm going to set the maximum point count to have a more decent number. For example, 6. Enter. Oops, the result is not very desirable, so let me repeat this again. Let me just delete this and repeat this again. Okay, let's duplicate the edge. And then use a review curve non-uniform. Set the maximum point count to, let's say, a higher number, let's say 7, and see how. Okay, this portion, the deviation is too much. Let's set this. Let's set to, let's say, 8. For some reason, the deviation here is a bit too much. I think, let me just set to 7 and adjust the curve ourselves. Okay, enter. So I'm going to adjust this curve myself. And proceed to do the surface. Let's use the sweep one rail. Okay, rail cross section should be this. Okay, enter, and we got like a surface over here. Click OK, and let's analyze the surface quality using Zebra. You'll notice that there is no proper alignment over here. They are all just positioned. We need to align them properly to curvature. But before that, let me just turn on control points and see whether we are getting good control points distribution. Looks quite okay to me. I also need to have this edge aligned with a continuity or implied tangent to this region over here. So what I'm going to do is select this curve, extrude it using the gumball, and click add object. Okay, to check the continuity. You can see that over here there's a bit of discontinuity, and I need to align this surface and match it to tangent over here. So let's do the match surface. Okay, match this to this surface and match it to tangent. Okay, take out refine, match by closest point will do. Okay, and yep, so now we are getting tangent match. Okay, so I'm gonna click before that, let's set this to preserve isocurve direction. Okay, so I'm gonna preserve the direction of this surface. Click OK. And now I can proceed to do a mesh. If there's any kind of misalignment, I might have to remesh this again. Okay, so let's do the match again. Match this to the edge here. And this time around, we need to set it to curvature. Okay, set it to curvature, and you might want to check to see whether there's some kind of misalignment. There's some misalignment over here, so you might have to click the refine match for the refinement on the surface. The refine match will actually add additional rows or control points in order to attain a better match. So you got to use it with careful consideration. Okay, so in this case here, I think I will just use the refine match. Okay, and I'm going to click. I could make sure that I'm using the preserve isocurve direction. Click OK. And seems fine now. Over here, I think the match is still fine. So I'm not going to rematch this. Okay. I can delete this. And now what I need to do is to create another curve here that will be used to trim off this region. And I reckon I could use back the original curve that was created as the base for the new curve. Okay, let's copy, paste to duplicate a new curve over it. I'm gonna press the control key, snap it here. Maybe I just off the zebra for time being. And let's scale this direction and move this downward. Okay. Let's just turn off the surface isocurve so we can have a better preview. Okay. Something like that. Okay, so I want to have a profile that is a profile curve that is something like that, so I can do a trim over here. Okay, so I think this should be fine, and we can proceed to do the trim. Cutting object is this. Object trim at this region is this. Okay, so I got something like that, and you get something like that. Okay. Now let me hide the curves. Okay, the next thing you need to do is to create the surface over here. And what I'm going to do is to create the cross-section profile using the adjustable curve blend and set 1 and 2 to both curvature. Okay, I do not want to tweak this. I think this is fine. The control point layout are fine. So I can click OK. And over here, I need to split this edge so that I can use this segment here as our cross section when we do our surface. To do that, you can go to Analyze, Edge Tool, Split Edge. Okay, select this edge. Make sure that the object snap, the end snap is turned on. We're going to split it at this location. Okay, now let's proceed to do a surface by using, say, something like sweep two rail. So first rail, second rail, cross section, this edge as a cross section. And now the A and B, we can set it to curvature because we want to have a smooth transition. Okay, and we might want to add slash. Let's add something like that and see the result. Okay, we have to turn on the zebra now to see the result. Analyze surface zebra. Let's do the adjust mesh. Okay, and make sure that it's set to something like 0.001 for fine refinement. And if the 0.001 is still not giving us like a good preview, you might want to bring this value even finer. So I can set to 0.0001. Click the preview so that we can analyze the surface. And yeah, we got curvature here, but I think let's see whether we can still improve the surface quality. Turn off this for time being. Let's turn on the control points. Okay, the control point placement are pretty okay. However, let me have some final control over this surface, see whether we can improve it further. I'm going to delete it and going to add more segment of cross section over here. Okay, I'm going to create a line, something like that, and maybe another line that and project this and this onto this surface, and then manually create our adjustable curve plane. Okay, something like that, so that we can constrain this part further and then repeat the process for this section. And I think I will want to duplicate the edge and then turn on the control point and see whether the result is good. I think the result is fine, it's pretty good. The control point kept at a minimum, so it's good. Okay, so let's create the surface again using sweep tool rail. First rail, second rail, cross section. Now I'm going to include this and this curve as our cross section, and then set A and B to curvature. I don't need to add slash because this will be used to control the profile, then click OK. And now let's hide these curves and let's join these surfaces and analyze surface zebra. Okay, I think the result seems to be cleaner now. Yeah, I can see the result appears to be cleaner than before. Okay. Okay. So now, let's analyze to see whether there are any gaps. H2 show H. Okay, great. So let's proceed to create the other half by using the mirror command. And click join. Okay, as you can see, we have a result that have curvature treatment all the way. Let's analyze the volume. Yeah, we got volume, so this object is producible. Okay, now let's analyze the surface quality using the environmental map. Okay. Seems fine to me. Okay, the result seems fine to me. Okay, with that, I come to the end of this demo. Hope it has been useful. See you. Bye.